Once again, the IDF did not deny the authenticity of this video. And if you are unfamiliar with the soldier's reference to the seed of Amalek, we have some context around that. The chant's reference to Amalek, a biblical tribal nation inhabiting the Negev and the archetypical enemy of the Jewish people, originates from the end of chapter 25 of Deuteronomy in the Hebrew Bible. In the land which the Lord your God gives to you as an inheritance to possess, you shall obliterate the remembrance of Amalek from beneath the heavens. A similar command is given in 1 Samuel 15, where the prophet Samuel tells Saul, the first king of Israel, that God has ordered them to go and proscribe the sinful Amalekites, make war on them until you have exterminated them. Now, there are a couple other interpretations of that depending on what you're using. That's also in the Old Testament of the Christian Bible, and that is an explicit call for genocide in that translation. That reference has also been invoked by Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. You must remember what Amalek has done to you, says our Holy Bible, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said in an October 28th press conference. And we do remember, and we are fighting. The paraphrase was also invoked in a popular Israeli song called Harbu Darbu. We've brought the entire army against you, and we swear there won't be forgiveness, sons of Amalek. Another lyric from that same song, every blank, last day will come. Bella Hadid, Dua Lipa, Mia Khalifa.
Yeah, okay, so I'm expecting congressional hearings immediately, right? Because I hear that any chance of potential genocide is something that is just the worst thing that could possibly happen, and everyone involved should be fired. But those aren't theoretical chants, and those aren't on a college campus. Those are soldiers who are going to actually execute that chant for extermination. That actually goes a little bit further than genocide. Genocide is targeting one ethnicity in particular and killing a lot of them. Srebrenica, where 6,000 Muslims were killed, was considered a genocide, okay? Wiping that race off the map is a Holocaust. So I don't, the songs, I'm not interested in your, oh, it's pop culture. No, that's not calling for genocide or worse. In pop culture is not an excuse, it makes it way worse. So those soldiers are not gonna be punished. I read the details. They said, oh, we're gonna pull them off after the war is over. In other words, you're not pulling them out. There's gonna be no consequences at all. Of course there's no consequences. The leader of the country referred to Amalek. That monster is talking about genocide. And we're gonna send $14 billion to commit genocide in Gaza? We should send $0. So look guys, when you're in a war, these awful things happen. That's why we said in the beginning, go for peace instead of endless war. But it doesn't mean you don't criticize when it does happen. So you see that an awful incident of that, and they're executing it. 19,000 civilians dead now, sorry, 19,000 overall dead, and 29,000 bombs dropped in an area the size of Las Vegas. Imagine you're in Las Vegas and they're gonna tell you, hey, we're gonna drop 29 bombs. Good luck. We don't know which, and they're 2,000 pound bombs, the largest bombs there are. America wouldn't drop more than 500 pound bombs in the worst fighting in Iraq. They're four times that size. We're gonna drop 29 of them. How scared would you be if you and your family were there? Now imagine 29,000 of them dropped. And then they sing about how they're gonna exterminate you. Israel has got to be infinitely better than this. And this is not how an ally or a democracy acts.
Yeah, I don't know the way in which Amalek is used, like colloquially, if it's like you're Satan or the devil, but if it is the case that you're saying you wanna wipe an entire population of people off the planet, that is not something we should incentivize, it's not something we should celebrate, it's something that we should censure. You just shouldn't be doing those kinds of things. I think, yeah, I mean, I said it earlier, like when you see these things, when you see this kind of behavior, it's bad behavior, you don't wanna incentivize it, you don't wanna reward it, you wanna censure it, and And like you said, like this is war. These are horrible things that are happening. You're going to, I mean, a lot of people, I just at the end of it, just remember that everybody involved in this is a human being. Yeah, you get conscripted into the military and you also are born wherever you're born. And if you're born in Gaza, you have a way worse life than most people on the planet. And that sucks. And I just want to make sure we're all using like the, I mean, I say this all the time. I feel like I'm a referee in a sport I absolutely hate. But you know, if you find you're 10 minutes from being Kanye West, go back and yeah. That's I just like try to see what tropes you're having creep in there. If this turns into like anything all Jews, then don't do that. I think everybody can still have like an opinion of seeing something like that, of singing a song. We remember put a boot in your ass, it's the American way, like all that stuff. So
yeah. So I just want to say one thing about that. Guys, we got to get back to humanity, okay? And so when I think it was 36 kids killed in Israel, and you look at that and it's heartbreaking. And now we've had thousands of kids killed in Gaza. And I keep remembering that 3-year-old we showed you yesterday with this giant scar across his head. And they have to try to explain to him that his parents are dead in Gaza. Be a human being in either direction. You have to call out both of those things. That's reprehensible. Both of those things are reprehensible. And then if you slipped into, hey, they're the bad guys and we should kill them, you've already gone in the wrong direction. You're missing the point. We shouldn't kill anyone. We should all remind ourselves that those 3-year-old kids could be our kids. Get back to humanity and decency. Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.